Good people of YouTube, my name is Spanner, welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2. So we just finished the Doors of Pharaohs, so let's go to the next area. And you can actually completely avoid the Doors of Pharaohs by just going up here. Oh, you actually hit me somehow. Got some germ armor. Over here, it's another one of these guys. Just backstab him. Got a dragon charm. Then we continue up these stairs over here. On this side, you will meet Gavlan again. He will remain here for the rest of the game. His inventory is always the same, so it doesn't really matter. Yeah, we go home. Continuing on. Here's another Gurm warrior. This guy will actually throw his axes. Got the gloves, and over there we will meet a crystal lizard. So we gotta hit him, otherwise he will continue. He will continue down the path and fall to the ground over there. On this side is another one of these guys. They don't really matter. Oh, hello. Okay, got the gloves. And I believe this is it. All we have to do is climb these stairs. Here we are. I'll just roll through these pots over here. Is there an item on this side? I don't think so. Yeah. And now we reach Brightstone Cove Tseldora. And here's a bonfire. Okay, from here, you see there are several enemies around. Some of them are on top of those wooden structures. There's also an item over there. We can break those. See, here there's nothing. If we go over to this side, there is a single worker doing some random stuff over here. We could just kill him and get all of this loot. A couple of souls, more souls. Yeah, only souls. This tower has some lacerating arrows. And now be careful about attacking these guys head on, because they can and will parry you sometimes. Let's get this guy on the ground. There are two of these boars here, a bigger version of the ones that are in Majula. What the hell just hit me? Arrows? Ow! I didn't see this guy approaching me from behind. Damn it. That kinda sucks. Okay, let's do all of this again, but now I can just go through here. There's an enemy in the tent. Let's see if more enemies would like to join me inside of this tent. Let's kill the boar. Get these guys off the towers. Even with this weapon that deals a lot of damage, still takes about 3 hits to break this. Okay, let's recover the souls. Okay, now inside one of these tents is a summon sign for Benhart. The guy with the blue sword we've met earlier. And we'll actually use him because there is a mini boss. A bit ahead. For now, let's get this guy. The Titanite Shard. Okay, now you see this building over here? There is a chest over there. And you can only get into that building by going over here, and we need to jump inside of that well. Okay, we broke the wooden roof, I guess. So now let's actually try to jump inside. I overshot it. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. There is another boar. Got some holy water. And then we can go up the ladder. Now, this chest is also a mimic. To deal with mimics, we can either attack the chest and kill it. The best option would be to kill it before it turns into the mimic itself. About 3 hits with this sword should do it, actually. But we're not going to do that. There's actually another way. Oh, I don't think I mentioned this the last time we encountered the mimic, but if you actually open the chest, it will eat you. You will die. There is a thing we can use. Where are... where are they? Ah! Lloyd's Talisman. They actually have another use. You can throw them at a mimic. And you can then pick up the item. And that's it. It'll put the mimic to sleep. Of course, we can still kill it. For souls. Okay, we are done with this little area. You can now continue here. You see those massive boulders on top of that, on the edge of this ledge, I guess. If you approach them, those guys will drop them and they will deal massive damage. There are some enemies here, let's see if I can lure them for the next boulder. Okay, we killed one with the boulder. Now we can climb these ladders. And we can pick up this item over here. Soul of a Brave Warrior. You can see more of the area down below. We'll be going down there in a moment. Got some peasant gloves. And there are some more enemies over there. Okay, so this does not apply since we're in Bonfire Intensity 1, but if you're on New Game Plus, or if you use an ascetic to reach Bonfire Intensity 2, once you get over here, you will meet the boss of this area. It'll come over on this cliff sides. It was quite surprising the first time I did New Game Plus. Really was not expecting it. And when the boss appears, you can just try and kill it and deal massive damage. The damage will remain for when you actually fight the boss, so that's something. Or you can just ignore it and hide, and the boss will go away eventually. Okay, so let's go get... Is this guy alive? Huh. So let's get Benhart over here so he can get his first summon. Although the next boss... it can be a bit awkward to deal with the next boss sometimes, but... not with a massive sword like this. Oh, I actually forgot something. Where is the bonfire? I want to light a torch. Alright. A lit torch will be very useful in this area, not because it's dark. The area is in fact well lit. But there are some enemies over here that really don't like torches, and they'll just run away from us. Spiders! There are also some of these sconces here that we can light up. Now, spiders will run away from the fire. And if we open this chest, there is a different type of trap, a unique type of trap. This will just trigger all of these spiders. See? They're just running away, not even trying to attack me. And there's just a couple of heavy bolts. Nothing that amazing. Oh, they're all dead. Huh. I thought there were more of them. Okay, let's light this. Here's the boss fog door. And over here, there is a secret door. There's a spider on the wall, but we can get the priestess set. Okay, let's... Oh, hello. We don't need the torch anymore. Oh, there are more spiders still. Well, it doesn't really matter. Let's go through the fog door. Okay, so we have the Prowling Magus and the Congregation. The Prowling Magus is that guy, this guy over here. He just casts dark magic. all of these are quite weak. They're just a bunch of regular enemies. There's just a lot of them. The Magus will cast dark spells, these two priests will cast lightning spells, and these guys, well, they're just hollows. That's why I said the sword will be pretty good against these, because there are a lot of them, so we can hit multiple at a time. Okay. Boss defeated. Benhart lives. Oh, and we got a slab. Okay, after you leave this chapel, got a cracked red eye orb, and there is this ladder. Over here there are a couple of items. These spiders are not hostile. Some skeptic spice. Okay, but the more important part is this NPC over here.
Yes, I can tell. It is written upon your face. You have doubts about something you did. I am Cromwell. Regret, anguish, disillusion, bewilderment. What wonderful gifts they are. Together, they are the essence of life. Don't you agree? But now, you're lost, bewildered by your own actions. You poor little thing. Yes, how tiny and frail are we. But if your heart is yet sincere, your sins will be forgiven. Now is the chance. Demonstrate your sincerity to me.
Okay, so this guy can absolve you of your sins. We haven't sinned. At a cost. It'll cost some souls. And he sells some rings, the white priest set, some dark troches, and a lot of miracles, and one hex.
Whenever you are ready.
Alright, moving on. For now we have to go here to reach the second bonfire. Let's spend some souls in Majula. Let's see, how am I doing for dexterity? 22. 24. Okay, I need 30. And then we'll level up something else. Maybe more vigor and endurance. Maybe even some more vitality. Who knows? It could be anything. Let's light a torch once more. There are still many more spiders to come. Right on this room. And they're all dead. Okay, here we see a white mage. They deal some damage, they throw some homing projectiles. Now there are a lot of ways we can go over here, and we need to get back to this bonfire again so we can do all of them. The best thing we can do here is reach the third bonfire. So we jump down here into this platform and over here. Got some more mages. Now, do not fall down the hole. Let's take the ladder instead. There's the bonfire, along with a bunch of spiders. As long as we have a torch equipped, this is no problem at all. Just gonna kill them so I can rest in the bonfire. Now the reason why we come to the bonfire that way is because this door is locked from this side. We can actually go the other way around and reach the grounds, but then we cannot open this door. There are a couple of mages around here. A basilisk. And you see, we see there a red crystal lizard. Oh, I've been invaded by Bowman Guthrie. Oh yeah, this is an NPC. And more spiders over there. Let's fight him in here. Okay. He's dead, let's kill all these spiders. Bad spiders. Okay, here is an item. Should really kill this guy. He's annoying me a little bit. Okay, good. Okay, now if these spiders that appeared didn't trigger, whenever you come here and pick up this item, they will come from over there. Is there an item in here? No. Okay, so don't fall down this massive quicksand pit. Let's light another torch. Let me just bring fire along with us. Okay, so as I was saying, here is a red crystal lizard. Those do not drop anything, they just explode. See? He exploded and killed me. I thought I would actually hit him from there, but apparently not. Okay, but we'll deal with the ground floor later. For now, we can do more stuff. Let's head back to the second bonfire. Okay, now we won't be going... Oh no, yeah, I will be going down. This is just the chapel. Give me the fire again. I'll take the fire. We dropped a bat staff. Okay, we can jump here and here for an item. Titanite chunk and twinkling titanite. Let's use a homeward bone. Ow. Stop it. Really? Actually wanted to jump down to the ground, but when I thought about it, my health was too low anyway. Fine. Guess I lost the souls that I had. Yeah, I should have went back and picked them up. I kind of forgot about that. Well, I had just leveled up, so it's not a big deal. Okay, now we can also go down here onto this platform. Pick up a large titanite shard. Let's head back to the bonfire. And now let's go across. Okay, you can either jump over there or you can grab onto this rope and just press forwards to slide across. Kill the crystal lizards. Let's see, I will be going over here first. Pick up this item. You can drop these barrels and they'll explode, but it won't accomplish much. Now we'll jump down here. Kill this mage. And there is an Estus Flask shard inside. Since we're here, let's not use a homeward bone. I cannot use it because of the damn spiders. Oh, that's right, I don't think it ever came up before, but if enemies are close by, you cannot rest at a bonfire. You also cannot rest if you've been invaded, or if you've summoned some players. Let's go here. And finish the first half of this area. Just light the torch so the spiders don't suddenly attack me. Okay, now for a more interesting part. Let's slide over here. Inside, you will find Pate and Creighton fighting, and we can aid whoever we want. But since I've already gotten Pate's armor, I will help Creighton because he will gift me his armor. So if you want everything, just do this. We got Pate's spear and the ring of thorns, and there was some charcoal resin here. No, I did it.
Thanks for your help. He was no pushover. Here, take this and go to my bubblehole down the way.
Now, if you help Pate instead and kill Creighton, Pate will also give you that key.
Here, these are for you.
There we go. Creighton's set. Okay, over on this door, there is... well, there's a spider. And nothing else. We can continue down this path a little bit, open the door. Here we have another torch. And the crystal lizards. Okay, got the lizards. We are now in a different area though. Oh, I missed that item up there. Oh well, we'll get it next time. Speaking of next time, it's a pretty good time to end the episode. So for now, thank you guys for watching, hope you enjoyed another episode of Dark Souls 2, and I'll see you all next time.